My life changed the day my husband bought me a new pair of shoes. Boots, in fact. Gum boots. And in my favourite shade of black. He was taking me to a part of the world that I never knew existed. A place where we would plant thousands of trees, shrubs and seeds. A place where the foundation of my family's memories would be shaped with the children we didn't yet have. A place where I would learn to become a farmer's wife, gumboots and all, on what would become my own sacred site. Whilst we experienced many peaks and troughs through the farming endeavours of ours, I found a purpose and a passion through those experiences. A love of growing food. I also saw how strongly this experience could impact on a child. The moment I watched my five-year-old, in a private moment all of his own, harvest our ripe and ready tomatoes, was the moment that I knew he understood something about food that so many of us don't. In his own mind, he had a purpose, a reason and a responsibility to ensure those tomatoes that he had sown from seed and watered and fed over time were ready to harvest. He also knew something that most of us don't, where his food came from. We all know that good food is essential for our health, our nourishment, and our survival. Yet the more often I get my own hands dirty in the soil where I grow food, the more I realise we've become so disconnected with such a fundamental resource. I want you to picture a young child pushing their hands deep into the soil. Watch that child's face as their mind and their hands are searching for something within that soil, something they can't see, but only feel. They're in their own moment. Consider how that moment can open up their hearts and minds to nature, to the very thing that allows them to think, to create, to discover, and to find their own self. Yet, we're forever telling them to wash their hands, clean up, come inside, taking that moment of spontaneity away. Ongoing research into the benefits of connecting children with nature is clear. It encourages creativity, it increases their physical activity, it improves cognitive ability and self-discipline. It even reduces stress. It also promotes a positive approach to good food and nutrition. Creating an opportunity for a child to grow food doesn't require a farm. This experience can be shared in the backyard, on a balcony, or even with a small pot and a few herbs on a windowsill. It's not about what a child can grow, but that a child can grow something, their own creation. I think if we can encourage that experience in a child, that's a wonderful gift. For us to be able to experience that with our child is such a precious gift that they could give us in return.